Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss on the topic Principles of Inheritance and Variation Part 4, and this video is presented to you by www.examhit.com. So the topics we are going to cover in this video is dihybrid cross, law of independent assortment, chromosomal theory of inheritance. So first of all, dihybrid cross. So as we have discussed in our previous video about the monohybrid cross, in which we have taken a one pair of character, which is height, having a different size, which is tall and dwarf. Now in dihybrid cross, Mendel has selected a pure breed of two pair of character and cross between them. So the two pair of character is color of seed and shape of seed, P seed. Okay, so the color is yellow and green and the shape is round and wrinkled. So after that, so as you can see, round and yellow, wrinkled and green. So the P generation, parent generation, will have the arrangement of gametes like this. So we have denoted this as a capital R and capital Y, and this one as a small r small y, because these are the recessive character and these are dominating character. So round yellow is a dominating character and wrinkled green is a recessive character. So after that, what happen is the arrangement of gamete take place. So this R will combine with this Y, capital R capital Y, and likewise this capital R capital Y, small r small y, oh sorry, capital R capital Y, capital R and capital Y. So all the gametes were round and yellow. Likewise, the arrangement of gamete of wrinkled green will take place like this, small r small y, small r small y, small r small y, small r small y, and likewise small r and small y. So the gamete form will be wrinkle and green, after which, so these are the gamete will cross with small r and small y, as you can see here, capital R capital Y, small r small y. So the f1 generation will be cross between these, and this arrangement of gene will like this, capital R small r capital Y small I. So this would be round and yellow, because dominating character will show up its trait and the recessive character will be will not be shown up. After which the selfing is done, which is self cross. So self cross will take place like this. So this will arrange with this, and likewise this will arrange with this. So capital R capital Y, capital R small y, small r will arrange with capital Y, and likewise small r will arrange with small y. So now we get the gamete round yellow, round green, wrinkle yellow and wrinkle green. So as you can see, the arrangement of gamete has taken place like this. Okay, so now I will arrange them like that. And R, Y. So I have considered it as a female and the other one as a male. Same gametes will be present here. So now how the arrangement will take place? Capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y, capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital Y, small capital Y, capital Y. Likewise, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, and this will arrange with this. Again, capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y, capital R, capital R, small y, small y. Likewise, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, small y, small y. Here, this will arrange with these four. Capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, small r, small r, capital Y, capital Y, small r small r, capital Y small y. Here this will arrange with all these four, capital R small r, so capital Y small y, capital R small y small y, small r capital Y small y, small r small y small y. So as you can see, these are 16 possibilities in which you can see this is round yellow, round yellow, round yellow, round yellow, because in this the dominating character has shown up. So here also round yellow, and this will be round green because two of the character arrange are of green. Round yellow, round green, round yellow, round yellow, wrinkle yellow because of small r, wrinkle yellow, round yellow, round green, wrinkle yellow, and one of the character is wrinkle and green will be shown up in F2 generation. So this is F2 generation. So this is the dihybrid cross. So after the dihybrid cross, Mendel has given a third law, which is law of independent assortment, in which he says that when two pair or trait are combined in a hybrid, segregation of one pair of character is independent of other pair of character. So these are the two pair of character, but the segregation of these pair of character, that is the separation of these character, and after that the combination of them will be independent of other pair of character. Okay, so as you can see that this R can arrange with this round, will round can arrange with green, also the yellow can arrange with wrinkle. It is not compulsory that round and yellow character is totally combined with each other. These both are independent from each other, but because of due to some arrangement take place, some of the seeds we get is round yellow and some of the seed we get is wrinkle green, but some of the seeds are also round and green, and some of the seeds are wrinkle and yellow too. So in dihybrid cross, the phenotypic ratio is 9:3:3:1. That means the round yellow is 9. So as you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 of them are round yellow. 3 of them are round green. See this one. 1, 2, 3. 3 of them are round green. 3 of them are wrinkle yellow. 1, 2, 3. And 1 of them is wrinkle and green. Okay. But this is the phenotypic ratio. This is the features we can see with our eyes. So now the genotypic ratio will be 1:2:2:4:1:2:1:2:1. So as you can see here that wrinkle and green, which is this and this one, capital R and capital Y, which is this, and likewise all other arrangement. So there are two arrangement with capital R and capital R small y. Two of the arrangement will like this, four of the arrangement will like this, but the character which they show, this will show the round yellow, round yellow, round yellow, round yellow, round green, round green, wrinkle yellow, wrinkle yellow, and wrinkle green. So as you can see, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So round yellow will be 9, and 3 will be round green, and 3 will be wrinkle yellow, and 1 is wrinkle green. So
This is the genotypic ratio in which the genes are arranged, or Mendel's factors are arranged like this, but the phenotypic ratio is totally different with the genotypic ratio. So here he says that the arrangement of these factors or these characters are independent of each other. Okay, there is no mixing between the two characters. So after that, two scientists which are named Baveri and Sutton, so they have explained the chromosomal theory of inheritance. So Mendel's work was not recognized properly because of due to some less communication, or and he shows his biological phenomena by using mathematics, which is not acceptable by the biologist, and its approaches was theoretical, not physical approach. There is no proof. So after which, in 1900, two scientists has conducted the same work independently at the same period of time, and they collected the full knowledge of nucleus and chromosome, which is present. So chromosome is present inside the nucleus, carrying the genetic material, and this genetic material is only transfer is inherited from one generation to another generation. So by using this law of independent assortment and some chromosomal theory, so combination of these two gives the chromosomal theory of inheritance. So they says that in homologous chromosome, so homologous chromosome, what happen is, so what are homologous chromosome? These are two chromosomes which are totally similar to each other in every matter, but carrying the similar gene, but having different alleles, and one of them is from father and another one is from mother. Okay, so like we take an example, if the color, face color or skin color of father is black and mother is white, so these two chromosomes which are homologous to each other carry the gene of skin color but having different allele. That means it has a black color allele and it has a white color allele. Okay, similarly, in if we take the example of pea, shape of seed and color of seed, so the shape round and wrinkle and color yellow and green, okay. So now the homologous chromosome will be like this. So both the chromosome will carry the gene of the shape, but this will carry round shape and this will wrinkle. Similarly, in this, both the chromosome carry the gene of color, but this will carry yellow and this will be green. Okay. So now there are two possibilities. So these are the homologous chromosome, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. So there are two possibilities. Okay. Now this R will arrange with this and this R will arrange with this. So it will be like this. R and Y, R and Y. So this will be like this. So this one will be the first possibility. And the second possibility will be this R can also arrange with this Y and this R can also arrange with this Y. Okay. So this R can also arrange with small y, and this R can also arrange with capital Y. So there are two possibilities. So this shows that the homologous chromosome carrying same gene but of different allele are independent of each other. So they can arrange with either of them. There are 50% chances of arrangement with this and 50% chances of arrangement with this. Also this R will also have 50% chances with arrangement with this and 50% chances with arrangement with this. Okay, so this will form the four different type of gamete. Okay, so this would be round and yellow, this would be wrinkle and yellow, sorry, wrinkle and green, this would be round and green, and this would be wrinkle and green. So four of them will be different from each other, sorry, wrinkle and yellow. Okay, so this Y is dominating yellow color. So wrinkle and yellow, round and green, wrinkle and green, and round and yellow. So four of them will be different from each other totally. Okay, so this is the chromosomal theory of inheritance. Thank you for watching this video. Subscribe Exam Hai on YouTube. Like our videos and please do comment.